Ms. Rand, in your previous discussions, you have stated that one of the consequences of the Berkeley Rebellion and of all civil disobedience is a breakdown of the rule of law and, in effect, a return to savagery in which men are ruled by brute force. This raises the fundamental question of what exactly is the nature of law and what is the purpose of law in society.
The purpose of law, the proper purpose, is to establish the general principles of conduct governing human relationships in a society, specifically to establish the principles of conduct which would respect individual right and prevent citizens from infringing the rights of each other. Therefore, the concept of law is inextricably tied to the concept of rights. Without the idea of some sort of individual rights, no rule of law would be possible. And in this context, it's interesting to observe that the concept of law historically originated really in Rome, where it was a very limited, very primitive concept, so that only Roman citizens had certain rights, or were supposed to have certain rights not granted to other human beings, which was certainly an improper idea philosophically. What is significant here is that it was the first time that man conceived of such a thing as a principle which pertained or belonged to in some possession of individuals and had to be respected by all other men in a given society. That is why the root of law really starts in Rome, in ancient Roman civilization. It is a principle pertaining to the protection, the definition of individual rights in the society of men.